everyone, this is Christina from Create a Smile, and today I would like to introduce to you our new release, which will be released on Friday. We are totally excited about the release because this will be the biggest release that we had so far. We will have 7 new stencils and 2 new stamp sets, and they will all be about Christmas, so this is just the right time for them to be released. I know you will be just as excited as we are. I would like to introduce some of the things that you can do with them today, and I will start with the stencil first. The first stencils that I would like to share with you are these intricate word stencils. So we have the Merry Christmas stencil with lots of Merry Christmas sayings in there, and the German version, that says Fröhliche Weihnachten. And because they are intricate, I would recommend using them with spray adhesive, but they are good for a lot of techniques, and I will show you 2 examples of what you can do with them. I used the German version, and the first thing I tried was some inking on patterned paper, and this got quite busy. Maybe I should not have taken the patterned paper in the background, but I just wanted to show you one technique of what you can do. This was just some white and blue chevron paper, and I used some Simon's damp island blue ink on that. I think blue is a nice Christmas color. You will see lots of blue and aqua in this release video, but this is just one example of what you can do, and I was really, really impressed when I tried to use embossing powder with it. Can you see all the intricate goodness on that one? You can read all the words very good, and I love all the shine on them. I think silver is just the perfect color for any Christmas stuff, any Christmas cards or layouts or whatever. So I'm totally excited about this. I think this turned out really, really nice, and I'm sure I will use this one on a card. I don't know what I will create with this, but I'm sure I will use this because I'm so happy how this turned out. The next stencils that I would like to show you are 2-step stencils. These are the first 2-step stencils. This is a funny word. 2-step stencil. Okay, these are the first 2-step stencils that we release, and let me show you these ones. So the first one is this one with the ornaments, and the second one is the snowman set, and they both have 2 stencils in them, which are 6 inch by 3 inch. So in all, this is 6 by 6, and you can use them in many different ways, and I want to show you some of them. The first thing you can do is just ink up the solid ones in one color and then add a different color with the stripes, because they have the exact same shape and you can totally line them up perfectly. So this is what I did. This is one example. So use some light colors for the first wash. I used some mint julep on here, some soft granite on here, and this was, I think, distress ink in squeezed lemonade, and then I used some brown ink on top, green ink on top, and red ink on top. Another thing that you can do, and this is totally awesome, is ink up the solid one and then add paste with the striped one. So this is what I did. I inked up the solid ornament in picked raspberry, and then I also mixed some picked raspberry ink into my paste to get a tone-on-tone look, and I think this looks really cool. Another example, and this might be my favorite, is using embossing powder for the stripes. So I inked that up with Evergreen Bow first, and then I used some Wow glitter embossing powder, and this turned out beautiful. I did not use the striped one here, I just inked that first and then used the solid one again for the embossing. Okay, so this is what you can do with these stencils, and I have 2 more examples using the snowman stencils. The first one is close to the one that I showed before. I just inked with white pigment ink on aqua cardstock, and then I used some clear glitter powder from Wow onto this to the stripes. I am not sure you can see this. Don't you think this looks just awesome? And I just added some pearls and a sentiment from one of the stamp set, and I'm good to go. And for the second one, I used, oh, this was not this one, but the the ornament again. I used the round ornament and inked just the edges to get some shading, and then you can totally put some images in there. So this is one cool thing that you can do with these stencils. Also, you could also, of course, only use the striped ones. I have not made an example for that, but this totally works. So there are many, many options for these, and I love them. These might be my favorite stencil from this release, because you have so many options to play with them. Another, not a two-step stencil, but a stencil set. This one has also one that are 3 inch by 6 inch, and you have two landscapes. So you have the landscapes with the trees and the little snowman, and you have some falling snow with just a snowbank. And you could totally mask off the snowbank and just use the dots. I just want to have both possibilities for you. And I created one card. Oh, well, it's not a finished card, but I created a background using both of them. I started with the dots first, so I masked off this area. I just spread some paste onto the dots, and then I used this landscape to create this little scene, and I think they work together very, very well. So this is what you can do with this stencil set, and of course there are many more options. You can ink them up, you can try to emboss, you can just do anything with them. And the last stencils that I would like to share today, I do not have any examples to share today, but I think these are just, you can just use ink or paste with them or spray them. And I know that this one was pretty popular when I showed a sneak peek on Facebook. So this is the Nautical Stars stencil, and this will be the Wave of Snowflakes stencil. And I know that you will love them. And I think that this one would also be good for the 4th of July or something. So this is not only Christmas related, this can be used for anything. Okay, so let's get to the stamp sets now. As I said, we will have two sets. And the first one I would like to share is the Cool Buddies stamp set. We have 3 different snowmen in there, 2 penguins, 1 fox, and a lot of tiny images that could work well for backgrounds. And a few sentiments, and we made sure to enlarge our sentiments because we know that the first ones that we released were quite small and had fonts that are kind of thin. So we went for a little more boldness on these ones, and I know that these are great for stamping and for embossing, of course. So let me show you some examples of what you can do. First, let me talk about the small images, because some of you asked me to show what you can do with all the small images that I include in these sets. I include them because I think that I don't want to waste any space. You should get the most out of your money, so I include these little images whenever there is some space left. And you can do lots of things with them. The first one is the hat, and the hat would go well on any of those critters. Okay, this one has a hat already, but the others could wear this. And I made one example with the penguin and the hat, and I think he looks, he looks like he was dancing. This is so cool. I think, the hat looks good on him. Just color that out very quickly, just stamp the sentiment to show you that these give a very good impression. Yes. Okay, and the next thing that I would like to share is the snowman. This is the biggest snowman, and he has this little snowball, and he's juggling with that. So we have the snowballs, he's juggling, and I use this cluster of 3 snowballs to ground him on. So he has lots of snowballs, he's sitting on some snowballs, and he's juggling with one. So this is one example of what you can do. And this little image could be used for a nice, very soft background, for example. I try to get this soft background for the fox. So I used the fox image and I colored him up like I did in the preview, in the preview banner. And this is, maybe it's hard to see on camera because it was Simon Says Stamp Sea Gloss ink, and this is a very light blue. And I just shaded a little bit on the bottom, and this is a nice scene that could go well on a card, and the card would be, we just need to add a sentiment and the card is done. Very simple. You will see a few more images of that soon, because the design team came up with gorgeous creations, and I know you will love them. Please make sure to hop over to our blog from Monday till Thursday to get more inspiration for that. These are just some of the samples that I made, but the design team is beyond genius. So the last thing that I would like to share is the Smiling Snowflake stamp set. And we have four smiling snowflakes and two stars that are smiling. But this, can you see this little snowflake? He's a naughty one, because I had the sentiment naughty or nice. And Annie said, and she was totally right, we need a naughty snowflake. So this is the naughty one. And I have one example where I stamped that. So I stamped a nice snowflake and the naughty one with the naughty or nice sentiment. Just some black memento ink, and then just some coloring with Copics. Very easy. You could emboss them, you could do anything with them. And I would also like to show you some examples of the small images, how to use them. One example that I have are the stars. So you could use a big star and make him like he's hopping, or yeah, he's followed by small stars. I think this row of stars really looks cool. I just used some light gray ink, so maybe it's hard to see. And the second one is this little kind of diamond, and I thought that maybe some of you do need some inspiration for the diamond. And I have three different options. The first one is do some emboss resist for a background. So I used some Pink raspberry and some worn lipstick just for that, because I wanted to have something different than teal all the time. So you could use, of course, any color. I used some Wow clear gloss embossing powder, super fine, with the image, and then I just used it to create a nice background. And I think you could also have some night sky colors for that one and create a nice night sky for that. The second option that you have is you could take it and create your own little snowflake. So you could also go with this set for very classic and elegant cards if you create the snowflake like this. And another option that you have is make a burst to have a backdrop for your focal point. So create a focal point by having a burst of them. And this is just one example that I made. This is not stamped very carefully, but this is one thing that you can do with this tiny stamp. And I think that these snowflakes are the cutest. And again, the sentiments are quite big, so I hope you like them. You could have the Be Merry, Naughty or Nice, but you can also have White Christmas or Happy Christmas or White Wonderland or Winter Wonderland. So I made them so I have the single words, so you can mix and match your sentiments. That was it for today. I hope you got inspired, and you'll hop over to our blog this week to get more inspiration. Thanks so much for watching.